Welcome back, folks. My name is Mead, and you're watching my Minecraft tutorial series featuring Terra Firmacraft by Biox. Gotten some requests for doing some of these, and I figured I'd go ahead and start, because why not? It's something new, it's something I haven't done before, and I like to learn as I go. So, off we go. Today we're going to be doing the sluice. We're going to show y'all how to make all the stuff, and what you need to do, and what you can expect to get out of it. So, first thing we're going to do is, I am in my test world right now. We're on peaceful, we're in NEI cheat mode, we're not worried about anything, we're just doing the tutorials. This is not, quote, legit anything, it's just, you know, I'm gonna be bringing in what I need, and we'll go from there. So what we're going to do is we're going to mark off the space that we need. And that should be most of it. Okay. So this is going to come in here. We need the water to travel all the way down, but not until it ends, basically. And then, oh good. So this is the problem that we're going to have now, because the rock starts so high, is you're going to have to do a lot more to, you're going to knock this down, basically. And you're going to have to punch your way through two of these, or find some metal first. So what we're going to do is we're going to get, where is it? Interestingly, the stone pickaxes are still in the game. We're just going to get a tin pickaxe, because that's likely to be, you know, one of the first things you'll get, a zinc or bismuth or whatever. So, tin pickaxe, there we go. Dig through just like that. Now, what we need, we're going to put that down there. Now, what we need to do is make a knife, because we've got to carve some bowls. So this plan is on the wiki, just like all the others. We have a knife, excellent, stone knife, there we go. Now you just take a log, put the knife above it, and carve some bowls. Now what you'll do is you'll take a bowl and just stick it back in the crafting table, and that turns it into a gold pan. It's not a pan made out of gold, it's a pan for panning gold. That's where the term came from, actually, but you know, that gamble didn't pan out, that's where that came from. You didn't pan anything out of the dirt, you didn't get anything from it. No gold nuggets from the risk that you took. So that's where that term came from. So what we need to do, we're over here. The other thing you need to, the very first thing you need to do, is see the. I can't point because I don't have a pointer, but right where the sand is, you'll see LC-159 B River and Forest. Those are the biomes. It's right above the seed, and there you can see it better there. So you have to be in a river biome. And this doesn't look much like a river, but that's just one of the vagaries of Terra Firmacraft land generation and biome generation. Sometimes you get the little tiny river biomes, so be on the lookout for those. I had one in Season 2, I believe. It was just a tiny little biome right outside my door, and there were only like 4 or 5 water source blocks, but it was enough to do this. So what we're going to need to do is, we take 3 planks and 3 sticks, and we get a sluice. Now this is going to place down, backwards, I think. Whoops. I don't remember. Maybe not. There we go. So yeah, you have to be pointing away in the direction that the water's traveling for it to drop. You have to have the hole at the other end for the water to go into. Because if you just plug that up, then it stops running. And you won't get any, you can't even open the interface. Or you can, okay, well, you can open the interface, but see, this is dark. That means there's nothing going to happen when you put soil or dirt or anything in through here. Now watch what happens when I break that block. There you go. The neat thing about this is, you know, you can throw dirt on, or you can throw logs onto fire pits now, and you can throw the ore directly into the bloomery and, you know, all the other stuff. Ooh, we're inside the dirt now. Okay. So what that means see it disappearing? Well, it's all filled up now, but you can put granite or gravel directly into the water flow. And when it hits this sluice, it will go into it. And I think it'll queue up, so you can do 5 minutes worth of gravel. And when it runs out, it'll fill back up. It'll take the gravel block. Yep, see, it just took one. So there we go. And from what I've heard is you want to have gravel, you want to do gravel to get ores, and sand to get gems. It's because sand is, the gems are still, they still have no use except to take up inventory. But, what was that? Oh, more zinc. The gold pan can now only be used on sand and gravel. And the gravel has to be, it'll give you a little reminder here. You have to use it on sand in or near a river, or gravel from under the water. And gravel sitting outside on top of the water isn't going to work. Now, I wonder if you can do this. If you could place gravel back and then use it, yes, you can. So that's a way to renew your gravel resources. You can get gravel from other places and put it back under the water. That will probably be going away relatively soon. I don't believe that's how it's intended to be used. But we have... Now let's see. We've got... This runs a little bit slower than it used to. So I think each one of these bowls will add 5 or 10, possibly. I'm not sure. The old numbers aren't worth worrying about, and the new numbers, nobody really knows. The wiki hasn't been updated quite yet, or if it has, I haven't seen it. So we're going to wait until this drops down to... We'll let it go to 39. And then we'll dump this in and see how much we get. So we're almost there. Okay, here we go. And dump 46. Okay, so we get 7? Looks like 7. Okay, 7 it is. So you get 7 of these from each one. And there is a chance for the gravel block to disappear when you're doing it with this. But by far the easiest way is to just dig the gravel up and dump it in. And then you'll have a sort of a queue system here and a ready-made supply of gravel. Now this may be actually wasteful for the gravel. We'll have to see. So you may not actually want to do this. Yeah, you don't want to do that after all. Because you throw the gravel in, and it takes it immediately when it has room, and wastes the rest. So you don't want to do that. You just want to throw in 3 or 4 at a time, and let them work. And then when it runs out, then you throw a few more. So forget what I just said. Don't throw them in and let them sit, because you'll just be wasting gravel. And I had really hoped that we would have gotten something out of this, but you'll get the small ores and gems from this sluice. And what it does is it checks in a 100-meter radius. in the horizontal plane and 60 meters down. And whatever it finds in the area, see, because I've been picking up this sphalerite, and maybe even the copper is close enough. Or maybe it's 50. Maybe it's 50 meters radius, 100 meter diameter. I'm not entirely sure, but it's a gigantic area. So it'll look in the whole area and find ores that are in the rock down everywhere, and it'll generate little pieces of them. It won't take them away from what's already in the ground. It'll just generate new bits of it and tell you and give you an idea of what's in the general area. So then later you can come in with a metal prospecting pick and go pinpoint, you know, all the stuff that you were getting the little ores out of. So if we found, you know, gold or nickel or something like that, then we would know that this would be a great place to you know, burn up a metal prospector's pick and take a look. So we're starting to run low on the soil again. Throwing in. Oh, that gives a lot more than 7. So yeah, you want to you definitely want to watch throwing in the whole gravel blocks, because you can waste a lot of that stuff really quickly. Okay. That is a quick and dirty tutorial on the sluice and the gold pan. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for tuning in, and I will talk to y'all later. Bye-bye.